Welcome back, tech enthusiasts. In today's video, we are diving deep into the world of Kubernetes and exploring its fascinating array of components. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting your journey with Kubernetes, understanding these components is crucial for harnessing the full power of this container orchestration platform. So, without further ado, let's jump right in. Before we delve into the details, let's quickly recap what Kubernetes is all about. Kubernetes is an open-source container orchestration platform that automates the deployment, scaling, and management of containerized applications. It provides a robust and flexible infrastructure for running applications in a distributed environment. Now, let's explore the diverse components that make Kubernetes such a powerful tool. We begin with the foundation of any Kubernetes deployment, the cluster. A cluster is a logical grouping of all the components within Kubernetes, creating a cohesive environment for running your applications. Next, we have namespaces. These named logical groupings help isolate different workloads within a cluster, allowing for better resource management and organization. Moving on, we encounter nodes, which are the virtual machines or underlying servers in your Kubernetes cluster. We have control plane nodes, responsible for managing the cluster, and worker nodes, where your applications or workloads run. The pod is the fundamental unit in Kubernetes. It represents an abstraction over a container and defines an application workload. Pods encapsulate one or more containers that share the same resources. Now, let's talk about the service component. Services provide a static IP address and DNS name for a set of pods, enabling a persistent address that remains even if a pod dies. Services also act as load balancers, distributing traffic among the pods behind them. To handle inbound traffic and manage routing, we have the Ingress component. Ingress translates HTTP/S rules to point to services, making it easier to manage external traffic flow. The API server acts as the primary interface for users to interact with Kubernetes components. It enables users to manage the cluster using the KubeCTL command line tool or by sending HTTP requests. Interacting with the nodes is facilitated by the Kubelet, which is an agent installed on all nodes. Kubelet allows users to manage and communicate with nodes via the API server and KubeCTL. If you want to leverage cloud services from providers like AWS or Azure, the Cloud Controller Manager allows you to link your Kubernetes cluster to the cloud service provider and utilize their specific offerings. The Controller Manager oversees various control loops that continuously monitor the state of the cluster, ensuring that the current state aligns with the desired state specified by the user. It helps maintain the health, availability, and performance of the cluster. To determine where to place pods within the cluster, we have the scheduler. The scheduler evaluates resource availability, constraints, and policies to make informed decisions, ensuring efficient resource utilization and load balancing. On the worker nodes, the Kube Proxy application provides routing and filtering rules for incoming traffic to pods, enabling network communication and ensuring requests reach the appropriate pods. For network-level security, we have network policy, which acts as a virtual firewall, defining rules and policies at the namespace or pod level, enabling network segmentation, isolation, and secure communication. When it comes to handling configuration data, ConfigMap allows you to decouple environment-specific configuration from container images, making applications more portable. For securely managing sensitive data like passwords, tokens, or keys, we have secrets. Secrets ensure the confidentiality and secure distribution of sensitive information within your Kubernetes environment. To provide storage capabilities, we have volumes, which allow you to mount storage within pods. Volumes enable data sharing across containers or pods, whether it's local storage on the node or remote cloud storage. For managing stateful applications, such as databases, StatefulSets provide guarantees about the ordering and uniqueness of pods. They help ensure proper read-write order or limitations on the number of containers. To maintain a stable set of replica pods, we have ReplicaSets. ReplicaSets ensure a specific number of replica pods are running at any given time, providing availability and scalability for your applications. Lastly, we have deployments, which serve as blueprints for pods. Deployments define how pods should be created, updated, and rolled back, simplifying the management of application workloads in Kubernetes. And there you have it, the comprehensive overview of the essential Kubernetes components. Each of these components plays a crucial role in creating a robust and scalable infrastructure for your containerized applications. Understanding these components not only allows you to harness the full potential of Kubernetes but also empowers you to build resilient, scalable, and efficient applications. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your fellow tech enthusiasts. And of course, Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more exciting content on Kubernetes, cloud computing, and the ever-evolving world of technology. Thank you for joining us today. Stay curious, keep exploring, and I'll see you in the next video.